母乳就会立刻就从他的乳房中流出来。
And Nanda Maharaj, he's always, there's always tears of love of Krishna flowing from his eyes.
And, 对于 Nanda 大君而言呢，他的眼中呢总是流淌着对 Krishna 的爱的，激动的泪花。
And the cowherd men in Vrindavan, they use everything.Even their wives and children, simply for Krishna's pleasure, not for their own. And the ladies in Braja, they will all have the mood of Mother Yashoda.
而那里的女士们，她们的心态也都是跟亚瑟的妈妈的心态相似。
They think of Krishna as their own son.
她们把 Krishna 看成是自己的亲生孩子。
And sometimes they will try to dress themselves to look like their own daughters just to please Krishna.
有时候她们甚至会把自己穿着打扮的就像自己的女儿那样，只是为了让 Krishna 高兴。
Oh, Krishna. And Krishna's friends, they always want to be with Krishna and to see Krishna. They cannot tolerate to be away from Krishna.
Krishna 的朋友们，他们总是想跟 Krishna 在一起，他们甚至不能忍受片刻跟 Krishna 的分离。
Even if Krishna will walk behind a tree, they lose sight of Krishna for a moment, it's unbearable for them.
即便是 Krishna 是躲到了树后，走到了树的背面。他的朋友们片刻看不到 Krishna 的时候，他们也感到难以忍受的分离之情。
And then the cowherd girls, the gopis, that they experience ecstasy just going to meet Krishna or in being with him.
而那些牧牛姑娘们，那些年轻的女孩子们，当她们跟 Krishna 相遇和 Krishna 在一起共处的时候，内心就感到极度的狂喜。
So the people in Vrindavan, they enjoy this sweet loving dealings with Lord Krishna.
Vrindavan 的居民们就这样享受着跟 Krishna 之间的甜美的爱的交流。
That although Vrindavan, Goloka is very opulent, the peopledon't try to enjoy the opulence. They're very simple. They're very basic village, simple people, like village people.
虽然 Vrindavan Goloka 充满着富裕，但是那里的居民们从来不会试图享受这些富裕，他们只是非常简单的村民。
And they're able to take, at the same time, these people.Are able to take part in all the different pastimes of Lord Krishna.
与此同时，在此期间，他们始终能够参与 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
They can understand the nature of Lord Krishna's pastimes.
他们能够深深理解 Krishna 逍遥时光的本质。
And there they enjoy food and drink, they enjoy the company of friends and relatives, and they enjoy being with Krishna.
They also enjoy food, and they enjoy being with Krishna. They also enjoy being with Krishna.
And Mother Yashoda would always want to feed her breast milk to him.
他作为文达文的一个小男孩，他的这种孩提的这种消失过，总是能给居民们带来快乐。而亚修的妈妈呢，总是想给Krishna喂奶和哺乳。And
Krishna appears to be just like an ordinary child.
Krishna 表面上看起来像个普通的小男孩。
He covers his opulence because he's enjoying the loving dealings with all the other people of Vrindavan.
他掩饰了自己的富裕，因为他只是想跟Vrindavan的居民有一种爱的交流。
But at the same time, although he's like an ordinary child, still he will perform these amazing pastimes which only he could do. So Krishna enjoys being in the mood of a cowherd boy, and he hides his godly powers, he hides his divine nature, he just wants to be an ordinary human.
Krishna呢就扮演着一个普通牧牛童的角色，他掩饰了自己神圣的神力，以及他神圣的本质，他只是
But at the same time, he enjoys having the goddess of fortune to massage his lotus feet, and he does things which only God can do.
与此同时，他还享受着幸运女神为他按摩莲花足，而且他所
So the in Goloka, the love between Krishna and his devotees increase much more than in Vaikuntha.
在 Goloka, Krishna 和他的奉献者之间的爱就在
So Narada is going to tell us why Krishna does not behave the same way in Vaikuntha as he does in Goloka. We know in Dwarka and in Ayodhya, Krishna is not so intimate with the deal, and there's more respect and reverence given towards Krishna. But in Vrindavan, Krishna is very, very intimate with the devotees.
我们知道在朵尔卡在尤迪亚，那里的居民们都非常的尊敬他，畏惧他，没有那么亲密。但是在文达文呢，Krishna和奉献者之间呢，有着非常亲密的关系。So
Ayodhya and Dwarka they're like a secret part of Vaikuntha.
Ayodhya 和多尔卡就好像是文达文的一个秘密的部分。But
they have the same kind of mood as Vaikuntha. The same, there's awe and reverence for Lord Krishna, or Lord Rama, for the personality of Godhead. In Ayodhya it's Lord Rama, but in Dwarka it's Lord Krishna. But in both cases, the devotees will be very respectful to him.
Ayodhya的主是Rama, Dwarka的主人是Krishna, 他们都是人格神手。 那里的居民们对他都是怀着尊敬之情。
Actually, Dwarka is superior to Ayodhya, and Ayodhya is superior to Vaikuntha.
实际上, Dwarka 是高于 Ayodhya, Ayodhya呢, 又超越了 Vaikuntha.
They're superior because they're even more opulent than Vaikuntha.
之所以他更加优越, 是因为他有比Vaikuntha更多的富裕。
So, we see that Lord Rama in Ayodhya, and Lord Krishna in Dwarka, he's never so much under his devotees. He's always over them. He's always, they're always below him and respectful to him, not like in Vrindavan.
在Ayodhya和在Dwarka，就 Krishna呢，从来不会处在他的奉献者之下，他的地位总是高于他的奉献者。
So in Goloka, the devotees there, they enjoy special pleasure, activity. They have very special pastimes with Krishna, and they can enjoy the highest sweetness.
在 Goloka, 那里的居民享受着跟 Krishna之间特殊的逍遥时光，而且享受着特殊的甜美之情。
So Narada Muni, he doesn't tell us what these pastimes are, not yet.
Narada Muni呢，到此为止还没有详细的阐释这些逍遥时光具体是什么。But
in Goloka, both Krishna and his devotees, they enjoy pastimes in which they're equal. They serve each other equally. The one doesn't dominate the other.
但是在Goloka, Krishna和奉献者之间，他们之间的逍遥时光呢，他们享受着平等的关系，而且彼此相互的服务着。So
Narada Muni says that place, Goloka, that is the most confidential place of the Supreme Lord.
所以拿达摩尼说道，Goloka这个居所，它是至尊主最为机密的一个地方。But
at the same time, Goloka appears like an ordinary place of the material world.
与此同时, Goloka 好像是物质世界的一个普通的地方。And
it's in Goloka Krishna shows the perfection of his pastimes.
正在Goloka，至尊主展示了他逍遥时光的完美。But
these pastimes can only be understood by very fortunate souls.
这些逍遥时光只有那些非常极度幸运的人们才能够理解。
So Goloka is greater than all the other, even the other places in the spiritual world. And Krishna in Goloka is greater than all the other forms of the Supreme Lord in different places in the spiritual world.
在Goloka的Krishna，他也要比灵性世界其他地方的至尊主的地位都更加伟大。
Krishna in Goloka is sometimes he's known as Hari, and Hari means one who steals the heart of everyone with his pastimes, with his beauty.
在那里呢, Krishna 有一个名字叫 Hari, Hari 的意思就是, 他用他的消失光, 他的俊美, 他偷取了所有人的心。
So why is Goloka so wonderful? Why is it so glorious?
Goloka, 它为什么这么光荣呢?
Because it's the most perfect of all the places everywhere. It's the most perfect because its purpose. It's beyond everything in the spiritual, beyond everything in Vaikuntha, everything in Dwarka, everything in Ayodhya is higher than all that.
因为在Goloka, 它是尽善尽美的, 它的一切, 它的目的, 都超越了Vaikuntha, 超越了Ayodhya, 也超越了Dwarka.
And in the material world, Mathura district, there in the material world, and in the Mathura district, Gokula is there. Gokula is Goloka's expansion on earth.
在物质世界的Mathura区域呢, 包含了一个地方叫Gokula，Gokula是Goloka在物质世界的扩展。
And it's also greater than Vaikuntha.
它甚至比Vaikuntha还要伟大。
So Narada Muni says, I'm trying to tell you about it, but it's very difficult to tell anything.
哪个Muni就说到了，我试图向你描述这一切，但这一切都难以形容。
Narada Muni said, it's like a jewel, I have this jewel, I've kept it in my treasure chest of my heart, but now I'm going to show it to you.
Narada Muni说道, 它就好像是我心之 心灵的宝盒当中的一个珠宝，我现在想要把它呈现给你。So
Narada Muni has a great eagerness to tell Gop Kumar about this, about Goloka and about Krishna and Goloka.
Narada Muni 现在就非常渴望向 Gop Kumar 讲述 Goloka 的 Krishna.
And he's going to tell Gop Kumar something which he never told anyone before.
他将要向Gopa Kumar讲述他前所从来没有讲述过的事情。So
he says, at the end of the Dwapara Yuga, Krishna comes to the material world.
他说在Dwarpa年代之末, Krishna降临物质世界。
And he comes with all of his partial expansions, and they come to this place, Mathura.
他带着他的部分扩展一起降临到了Mathura区域。
And Krishna comes at that time, it's to satisfy his own desire, that he's eager to enjoy his pastimes with his devotees.
他降临是为了满足他自己的渴望，满足他自己的欲望，去享受跟奉献者之间的逍遥。
So Krishna comes to earth at the end of the Dwapara Yuga.
因此, Krishna 是在 Dwapara Yuga 之末降临地球。
And all of these great devotees, they all come with him to take part in his pastimes.
所有这些伟大的奉献者都参加了他的逍遥时光。
And they assume many different forms, they all assume many, they appear in many different ways. So Krishna gives up his attack, he gives up Vaikuntha and the other places in the spiritual world, and he leaves all of servants in the Vaikuntha and in Dwarka and Mathura, Ayodhya, and he comes to the material world to perform his pastimes.
Krishna 呢就放弃了外昆塔，放弃了灵性世界所有其他的地方，他也离开了在外昆塔、阿尤迪亚、多尔卡的那些仆人们，只是为了在降临物质世界来降临他的逍遥时光。
Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and all the forms of Vishnu, they're all included in that form of Krishna. So when Krishna came to Mathura, he brought with him all of his expansions with him.
当 Krishna 降临 Mathura 的时候，也把他所有的扩展都一同带来了。They're
not different from him, but at the same time they have their own identity.
他们跟 Krishna 没有区别，但同时他们也有自己的独立的身份。So
Krishna doesn't worry about Indra in heaven. He doesn't worry about all these people. He gives up even Vaikuntha. He gives up all the opulence of Vaikuntha, and he comes to Mathura.
Krishna 丝毫不担心天堂的国王 Indra. 他放弃了 Vaikuntha 的富裕，来到了 Mathura.
And he even puts aside, he neglects Mahalakshmi, the goddess of fortune. No, they're all very devoted to Krishna, but Krishna's coming for a very special purpose. He wants to enjoy the mood of Vrindavan. He wants to enjoy the happiness of the company of these special devotees who enjoy this Vrindavan atmosphere. The only the devotees of Vrindavan are able to satisfy Krishna by taking part in his very special pastimes. So on earth there is Gokula, right? Goloka is in the spiritual sky and Gokula is on the earth. And Gokula also shows very special qualities which are sometimes not found even in Goloka, in the spiritual sky.
Goloka 处在灵性天空，而 Gokula 呢是在地球，但是在 Gokula， 它甚至展示出在 Goloka 没有的特殊品质。
So by Krishna's mercy, he becomes visible to the people people in this world who have good devotion for him, right? The people in Vrindavan, Krishna shows himself to all these people because they have good devotion for Krishna.
Krishna 呢是出于他自己的仁慈，才在这个世界，在 Vrindavan， 让世人看见他自己，展示给他的奉献者们，因为他的奉献者们对他怀着特殊的奉爱。
And Gopkumar knows that when he was in Vaikuntha.Sometimes the Lord of Vaikuntha, Lord Narayan, would disappear. He would go away.
Gopakumar 在 Vaikuntha 的时候，有时候 Vaikuntha 的主 Narayan 呢，有时候会消失，会离开那里。
Lord Narayan would come to the material world sometimes. He would leave his place in the spiritual world to come to the material world.
有的时候主 Narayana 会离开灵性世界来到物质世界。
So different people, they will describe Krishna in different ways. Sometimes they will say he is the master of Vaikuntha, and others may say he is the Mahapurush who has 1,000 heads.
不同的人，以不同的形式描述着 Krishna。有的人描述他是 Vaikuntha 之主，有的人描述他是 Mahapurush， 有着一千个头的人。
And some say that when Krishna came to Mathura city, that this is Lord Narayan.
有的人甚至说。当 Krishna 来到马祖的时候呢，这个是主 Narayana。
And some say it's Lord Vishnu, and some say it's Lord Keshava, who is in the milk ocean, lies in the milk ocean. That's Mahavishnu.
有的人描述他是 Vishnu， 有的人描述他是 Keshava， 躺在牛奶之羊的。
So different people, they understand Krishna, they understand the personality of Godhead in different ways, according to their own ability, their own understanding.
不同的人，他是根据各自的理解，根据各自的能力，对人格守神怀着不同的理解力。
So,People have their different visions about Lord Krishna's position. Or who is the personality of Godhead? Some say Vishnu is supreme, some say Mahavishnu is supreme, and some say Keshava is supreme.
就有着各自的意见，有的人说 Vishnu 是至高无上的，还有的人称 Mahavishnu 才是最高的，还有人说 Keshava 才是最了不起的人物。
Or some say Lord Shirodakshayi Vishnu is the supreme because Brahma takes birth from him.
还有的人说 Chiyodapsha Vishnu 是至高无上的人物，因为主 Brahma 是从他那里诞生的。
Yeah, Shirodakshayi Vishnu is actually Keshava. When we say Keshava, that's the name for Shirodakshayi Vishnu.
Shirodakshayi Vishnu 他就是 Keshava. 当我们谈 Keshava 的时候，指的就是 Shirodakshayi Vishnu.
Keshava means he has beautiful hair. So Lord Shirodakshayi Vishnu has very beautiful hair.
Keshava 的意思就是长着一头美发的人，因为 Shirodakshayi Vishnu 他的头发呢非常的美丽。
So Krishna has very beautiful black hair, and his hair is always nicely combed.
Krishna 呢，他有着一头非常美丽的头发，而且呢是梳理的整整齐齐的。
And Krishna never has any white hair. He has no gray hair.
从来不会在 Krishna 那头上找到一根白发，也找不到一根灰发。
No, he's always young. He doesn't grow old.
他是青春年少的，永远不会显现出老相。
So different sages, different devotees, they understand the Lord, the personality of Godhead, in different ways, according to their own realization and their qualification.
不同的圣者们。就根据他们各自的觉悟、各自的资格，对主呢怀着不同的理解。
Actually, all these forms are all included within Lord Krishna.
实际上，所有上述的种种的形象都包含在主 Krishna 的体内了。
So we may wonder how could they all have so many different opinions about Krishna's identity?
我们可能就会提出这样的疑问：为什么不同的人对 Krishna 的身份都有不同的理解呢？
Because these people, they're supposed to know the scriptures, so shouldn't they be able to know the full identity?
因为这些人呢，本来应该对于经典有着充分的理解，那么难道他们不没有认识到 Krishna 完整的身份了吗？
But we should understand these men have simple intelligence. Their intelligence is there, but they're simple. They cannot analyze Krishna because it's just too difficult to understand Krishna.
就是这些人的智性非常简单，他们不能分析 Krishna， 因为 Krishna 太难以理解了。
And they know, you could also say they know the truth about Krishna, but they want to describe.The Lord in this particular way.
也可以说，这些人呢，他们实际上是了解有关于 Krishna 的真理呢，但是呢，他们就想以特定的方式来形容 Krishna.
They say that if you glorify any one of the Lord's incarnations, it's the same as glorifying all of his incarnations.
他们说，如果你荣耀 Krishna 的任何一个化身，那都是结果都是一样的，就是他都荣耀了 Krishna 所有的化身。
So, the Lord of Goloka brings his own abode. He brings his own people, everything. He brings everything here to this earth.To perform his own pastimes.
因此 Goloka 之主他把他的居所他的人员他的一切都带到了这个地球来上演他的逍遥时光。
Uddhava is also very dear to the residents of Vrindavan.
对于 Vrindavan 的居民而言 Uddhava 对他们也是非常至亲至爱的。
And Narada Muni says to Gopkumar, and you are from Braja yourself, so you don't have to worry.
Narada Muni 对 Gopkumar 说道，你是来自 Braja 的，所以你不用担心。
So I'm going to say something very confidential.
我接着就要跟你讲述一些机密的话题。
He's going to describe the opulence of Goloka, the special opulence of Goloka.
他接着就要描述 Goloka 的特殊的富裕。
And Narada says, you know, because you're all from, you're all Braja people, so Narada said, in this house, because Narada's in Uddhava's house, he said, I can speak without worry because I know you're all Krishna's people, you're all from, you're very dear to Vrindavan.
嗯，那么因为他们在 Uddhava 的家中，所以呢，哪儿的目的就告诉他们俩说，我知道你们都是 Krishna 的亲信，所以你们不用担心。
You're qualified to hear this knowledge when I'm going to speak.
你们是有资格聆听我接着要给你们讲述的话题的。
So Krishna's sweetness in Goloka and Krishna's mercy in Goloka is greater than anywhere, any other place.
Krishna 在 Goloka 的甜美 ，Krishna 在 Goloka 展示的仁慈，远远的要超过任何其他的地方。
The special pastimes where Krishna becomes controlled by his devotees are not seen any other place.
在任何其他的地方都看不到 Krishna 被他的奉献者所控制的这种逍遥时光了。
So Nanda Maharaj's many fields, because he has many cows, so he has a big land. So all of that land is enriched with the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
Nanda Maharaj,Nanda大君呢,拥有很多的母牛,因此他拥有很多的土地。所以在这些土地上呢，都充满着 Krishna 在上面上演的逍遥时光。
So Narada Muni is going to explain the different features of Krishna's glories in Gokula.
那Narada Muni 将要描述 Krishna 在 Gokula。他所拥有的特殊的特征。
And first of all, Narada speaks about Krishna, about his godly opulence.
首先呢 ，Narada Muni 将要讲述的是 Krishna 的他的神性、神圣的特性。
This land of Vrindavan is so attractive that even the goddess of fortune, she chose it as a place of her pastime.
这个 Vrindavan 这个区域呢是这么有吸引力，连幸运女神也选择了这个地方来作为她从事逍遥时光的地方。
Although the goddess of fortune, she is not attracted by powerful controllers like Lord Brahma or Lord Shiva, but she's attracted by the beauty of Vrindavan.
像 Brahma Shiva 这样的统治者吸引，他却被 Vrindavan 的美丽所吸引着。
Mahalakshmi, she attracts everyone in the material world. We're all attracted by her opulence. We want her blessings, but she's attracted to Gokula.
Mahalakshmi 被物质世界的所有的人都想。都渴求渴慕 Mahalakshmi 的富裕和渴望得到他的祝福，然而他却被 Gokula 所吸引。
And Mahalakshmi, she comes to earth. She comes to Vrindavan on this earth. She's the wife of the Lord of Vaikuntha. She's the Lord Narayan's wife, but still she comes to earth because she's attracted by the beauty, the opulence of Vrindavan.
Mahalakshmi 降临到这个地球，虽然她是主 Narayan 的妻子，她却被 Vrindavan 所吸引着。
In Vaikuntha, Lakshmi has many duties to perform in the service of Lord Narayan. But when she comes to Vrindavan, she's free to enjoy herself all the time.
Mahalakshmi 在 Vaikuntha, 她在对主 Narayan 的服务当中呢，有许多职责要履行。但是，当她来到 Vrindavan 的时候，她可以自由自在的，一直不断的在享受。
But still, the goddess of fortune, she's attracted to come to enjoy Vrindavan.
即便如此，幸运女神也被吸引着。
Because Lord Krishna appears here, so it attracts the goddess of fortune also to come for her pastimes. So Narada Muni is describing the opulence of Vrindavan. He said, any treeOf its parts can fulfill all the desires of anyone who asks. Whatever they ask, they can get from any tree.
Narada Muni 就开始描述 Vrindavan 的富裕。在 Vrindavan, 每一棵树都能够满足任何人的愿望和要求。
But in Vrindavan, Krishna doesn't want to enjoy these things. He just wants to enjoy his pastimes with his devotees.
然而在 Vrindavan, Krishna 呢并不贪求这些，他只想享受跟他奉献者之间的逍遥。
So a person who comes to these trees, he can fulfill all of his ambitions. He can desire anything from these trees.
任何人如果来到这些如愿树面前，这些树都能满足这些来前来提要求的人的任何的野心。他的任何的愿望能满足他的一切愿望。
So the trees of Vrindavan have so much opulence. How can they keep it secret?
Vrindavan 的树拥有这么多的富裕，那么他们怎么能够保密呢？
How could this place of Vrindavan? How could it be a place for?Be a suitable place for Krishna's pastimes when it's so opulent.
Vrindavan, 它这么富裕，那它怎么能成为 Krishna 的 一个消时光的合适的地点呢？
So Krishna does not show these opulences of Vrindavan unless it's for his pastimes.
除非是为了 Krishna 在其中上演消时光，否则的话 ，Krishna 是不会展示这里的富裕的。
Yeah, Krishna, because if there's no need for them, then Krishna doesn't show them to everyone. But Krishna's pastimes are always going on in Vrindavan. And just sometimes, not very often, sometimes the opulence of Godhead will be seen in Vrindavan.
只是在有些时候，而不是经常，能够Krishna 的富裕能够被展示出来。
Because the sometimes if he shows the opulence, it can disturb the pastime.
因为如果他展示出自己的富裕的话，就会干扰到这种消时光。
Okay, so we will stop.
那我们讲课吧。接下来我们看一下有什么问题。
Yeah, any question?
Now there's no question. Yes, Mara. Here are some questions. The first, 第一个是喜宝。顶拜咕噜和老师们，这段时间我被抖音里的旅行和神话故事吸引了，然后念诵和日常萨达呢，就变得像是赶作业一样，没品质。虽然内心提醒自己专注于灵性学习，但是心意却又欺骗自己。时代前进了，全民在玩抖音，难道你要回到原始社会吗？请问咕噜，我如何才能从玩抖音的罪恶感中解脱出来啊？感恩。
Yeah, translate.
So, Xibao is paying obeisance to Guru and the old teachers. And during this period of time, she had been attracted by that software called Douyin in China. It's very popular.
What is it? Douyin?
There are video, short video in this everybody can put their short video, including themselves and others, and how the others, they are traveling, how they are playing their games, all kinds of things, how they are cooking. They can put all kinds of short video in thisWeChat, online. So this Mataji has also been attracted by this short video about the traveling and also the tell mystic stories and her sadhana and chanting slackened because of that.Becomes like a routine, no taste, no quality.
No.
Although she reminds herself that she should be absorbed in this spiritual practice, but my mind cheated me that the time is moving forward. People all over China, all over the world are watching this Douyin. So why are you, why do you want to go back to the original society? So her question is that how can I get rid of this guiltiness of watching playing with Douyin?
So you have to be armed with knowledge. You have to understand that these videos are not going to save you from the problems of life, birth and death.
你需要用知识来武装自己，用知识的武器武装自己，你要告诉自己。 就是这个抖音，这些短视频不会把你从生死的活生生的现实当中拯救出来。
There are always going to be distractions to try to take you away from Krishna.
有各种各样的吸引人的事物，想要把你的注意力从 Krishna 那里拿走。
We're always looking, trying to find something else to satisfy our senses. Gross or subtle.
我们永远都是一直在寻找着，无论是粗糙还是精微的这种让我们感到粗糙的感官享乐和精微的感官享乐，我们都在努力的寻找着这些事物来满足我们自己的。
You know, we watch, sometimes before you're going to cinema or you're watching television, and we can do these things also for a long time, spend hours watching television and watching movies one after another. It's all useless, waste of time.
在此之前呢，人们，我们会去电影院，或去看电视，长时间的坐在电影院或者电视之前追剧，看着一个又一个的电影和一个又一个电视节目。 但这一切都是浪费时间，都是没有用处的。
We just simply become more forgetful of Krishna, and the time is lost. Valuable time is lost.
我们忘记了 Krishna, 时间呢也被浪费掉了。
And no benefit. There's nothing. You're not getting any benefit at all from watching these silly things.
从观看。 看这些愚蠢的视频当中，得不到任何的好处。
So we have to control the mind. You have to control the mind by good knowledge, intelligence.
你必须通过知识，通过良好的知识，通过智性控制心意。When
we become convinced about the importance of Krishna consciousness. Then you'll put these things aside to focus more on devotional service.
当我们全然信服了 Krishna 知觉的重要性，就会把这一切，置之不理，放在一边，从而专注于奉爱服务。So
you have raised a very important point, I'm sure. As you say, people all over the planet, they're spending their time watching these things and wasting their human life.
所以您提到了这一点是非常好的，您说到了就是全民都在玩抖音，那他们实际上都是在浪费时间。So
we say the blind follow the blind. You have to be intelligent. You have to not follow the blind people. You have to understand where you want to go.
有一句话就叫盲人引导着盲人，你必须要有智慧，不追随那些盲人，而要知道自己的目的地。
Krishna told Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita, armed with knowledge, stand and fight.
Krishna 在《博伽梵歌》当中教导 Arjuna, 以知识为武器, 作战吧。
But you will have to fight the enemy called lust, the desire to want to enjoy the senses.
我们必须要跟色欲这个敌人作战。色欲呢，就是想要感官享乐，感官享乐的愿望。
Human life is being wasted on all of these stupid things.
人体生命就由于这些种种的愚蠢的事物就这样白白浪费了。
So you have to be very careful and you know, it's just like smoking cigarettes or drinking, we get addicted to these things, we become attached.
所以您要非常小心，这就有点像有烟瘾和嗜酒酒瘾一样，人们就越来越变得沉溺其中。
And the more you watch, the more you become addicted, and the more you waste your time, waste your valuable life.
你越看这个抖音呢，你就越上瘾，结果呢就越浪费了的生命时间。
Just, we become, just like in a city, they put many bright lights up everywhere. So we become attracted to go and see the lights, and we see, you know, dazzling lights of the material world, and we're thinking very nice.
就像现在呢，在许多城市呢，他们都会有那个灯光秀，就是有那种音乐喷泉啊。就是展示这个灯光幻影，然后人们就这样就被物质世界这些炫目的光芒所吸引。
But we have to know that beauty is a very temporary and illusory. It's not reality.
但是我们要知道，这一切美丽既短暂又是幻象的，根本不是现实，不是真实的。
So don't be blinded, don't be attracted by these things. You have to really try to control your mind and senses.
所以千万不要变得盲目，被这些事物所吸引，要控制自己的心意，控制自己的感官。
Like young children, young children become attracted by these things, so...Young children, they're not very experienced of the material world. They're not trained to control their senses.
就像小孩子们，因为他们年幼无知，没有经验，所以就会被这个物质世界这些炫惑所吸引，他们就没办法控制自己的感官。
So don't be a child. Grow up.Be intelligent, don't waste your time.
不要总是那样小孩子气，要长大成熟有智性，不要浪费时光。
By some good fortune, you have come to Krishna consciousness. Now you have to take this Krishna consciousness very seriously.
由于好运，您才接触了 Krishna 知觉，您必须得认认真真的对待 Krishna 知觉。
Every moment lost can never be bought back. You've wasted so much time, and you've polluted your mind with all of this nonsense.
的分分秒秒都是无法挽回的，你已经浪费了时间，并且让自己的心意受到了污染。
所以
不要做这些蠢事。
You must become more careful to utilize your time properly in the service of Krishna.
你必须要小心谨慎地利用宝贵的时光来为主 Krishna 做服务。
There are so many things to be done in the service of Krishna. so many books to read, so many slokas to memorize.
还有那么多的服务等着做，有那么多书籍要去阅读，那么多的时节需要去记忆。
So you have to try to follow. Try to take more control over your actions. Don't become just a godas. That is a godas, a servant of the senses.
所以您得控制自己的，知道自己的行为，不要做一位 godas。
Okay, any other question?
Okay. Pushpa Sara Devadasi. 请问 Gurudev, Vishnu 和 Mahavishnu 有什么区别?
Well, there are three Vishnus. There's no difference, just different names according to the function. Mahavishnu is Vishnu laying in the conchial ocean.
Mahavishnu是躺在元阴之阳的。
And Garbhodakashayi Vishnu is Vishnu in the universe, who gives birth to the, who from the navel the lotus flower comes and Brahma takes birth. That's Garbhodakashayi Vishnu.
Garbhodakashayi Vishnu呢是从他的肚脐诞生出主 Brahma 的那位 Vishnu.
And Shirodakashayi Vishnu is the Lord in the heart, and he's also living in Sweta Dweep on the milk ocean.
Shirodakashayi Vishnu是众生心中的这位Vishnu，他居住在Sweta Dweep，在牛奶之洋上面的Sweta Dweep.
But they're all Vishnu. They are called the Purusha avatars, who do the work of the creation. So they have different names because they're doing different functions, but otherwise there's no difference.
这些都是不同的名字而已，因为他们所从事的功能不一样，否则的话，他们是都是一样的。嗯。Yeah.
Any other question? How you want it?
还有，下一个是 Sumukhi Radha, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj, 主持和奉献者们。 请问，Guru，您可否为我们解释一下清晨图提拉克的时候唱诵的 Krishna 的另外12个名字都是什么含义呢？
Oh, the significance of the different names when we put tilak on the body.
No, the meaning of these 12 names of Krishna.
Yeah, well. 12, yeah, they're names, different names. There, Prabhupada explains these are different temples on the body, that on the body there are different temples, and we decorate the different temple, just like you have a temple, you decorate the temple. So we decorate the body, the temple of the body, with the tilak.
就像如果我们有庙宇的话呢，我们会装饰这个庙宇。所以呢，就是在我们身体的这些庙宇呢，我们就用提拉克来装饰这些庙宇。
So different names are chanted for different parts of the body.
针对躯体的各个部位，我们会吟诵不同的名字。
But I don't know, I've never read anywhere about the particular significance of each name in each different place.
但是呢，我也不知道，我也没有读过，在每个地方各个部位的不同的名字，它们的重要，它们的各自的重要性。
Prabhupada just simply described it as the temples of the body.
Prabhupada只是简单地把它们形容为躯体各个部位的庙宇。And
they're all different names of the Supreme Lord.
而且它们都是至尊主的各个名字。
So different parts of the body, the Lord resides there in that particular name, you could say.
至尊主播，他居住在躯体的不同部位，你可以说，就是至尊主居住在那个特定部位的名字。
So, I don't know about particular significance of the name for each place.
我不知道，就是每个特定的部位的这些名字的这些重要意义。
We know when we put tilak on the forehead, we say Om Keshavaya Namaha. So Keshava on the forehead.
在额头上涂。 涂提拉克的时候就会念Om Keshava Namaha， 所以 Keshava 就是额头上的这个部位的名字。
But I cannot tell you why Keshava is there on the forehead. I just accept that this is the Lord, this is the name we chant. I'm a blind follower.
我也不知道为什么就是在额头这个部分要唱诵 Keshava， 我只是盲目的接受而已。
I'll try to find out.
我会努力的去发现这个重要意义。
Any other question?
下一个是Rajendra Prabhu的问题，顶拜Maharaj，顶拜翻译和主持，为何 Om 为超然的原因，以太中的声音还有哪些呢？ Why Om is the transcendental original sound? And what else are there? Exist in the ether. What else? A song exists in ether.
Well, Om is the sound representation of the Supreme Lord.
Om 是至尊主的声音代表.
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Pranavam sar. Pranava sarva vedeshu, that I am the syllable Om in the Vedic mantras. So in every Vedic mantra it begins with Om, and this represents the Supreme Lord.
Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》当中就说了这个时节，他说我是伟大曼陀当中的。 Om 这个音节，所以 Om 是超然声音，所有的 mantra 它都起于 Om， 所以 Om 就代表至尊主。
He's asking why is it transcendental?
嗯，the question is that why is Om is the original, the sound.
Well, first of all, we say everything comes from sound.
首先呢，一切都是从声音开始的。
The elements, the creation of the elements begin with sound. Sound is there in the ether. So it's the first element in the material creation.
So, 在这个物质创造当中的第一个元素就是声音，以太，因为声音是存在于以太当中的。
And we hear about Brahma. When Brahma took his birth from the lotus flower, he wanted to understand where he was from. He couldn't find out where he was from or what he should do. Then he heard sound, and the Lord vibrated ta pa, the two syllables ta pa, telling him to do austerity. So sound was there in the beginning, before the creation of Brahma.
When Brahma, 他是从一朵莲花当中上面诞生的，所以当 Brahma 诞生之后呢，他就不知道他自己是他的起源是在哪里，他应该做什么。这时候呢，他就听到了两个音节，他怕。所以这时候他就开始从事苦行，因此呢，就是在创造之初，这个音阵就已经存在着了。
So, in the spiritual world, there's also sound. Krishna plays the flute, right? And Krishna's flute playing is the sound of the Gayatri Mantra.
世界呢有那个笛音，Krishna 吹奏着笛子，他吹奏出了这个笛音呢是 Gayatri Mantra 的这个声音。
So Gayatri, Lord Brahma got initiated in Gayatri Mantra.
这样呢 ，Brahma 就被启迪，开始吟诵 Gayatri Mantra.
Some people say.No need for second initiation. They don't want to get second initiation. But Lord Brahma got second initiation. Lord Brahma took Gayatri Mantra.
有的人就认为有这种观点，没必要二次启迪。他们也不想二次启迪。可是我们看到 Brahma 他也得到了二次启迪，念诵 Gayatri Mantra.
So the Gayatri Mantra is transcendental sound.
因此 Gayatri Mantra 是超然的声音。
The Maha Mantra is also transcendental sound.
而 Maha Mantra 也是超然的音阵。
There is a Golokera Premadan Harinam Sankirtan, that the holy name descends from Goloka, from the spiritual world.
所以这个世界 Golokera Premadam Harinam Sankirtan 呢，圣名是从灵性世界，从 Goloka 降临的。
Yeah. All right.
好，下一个 Rukmini Devadasi， Rukmini Devadasi 顶拜 Guru， 感恩翻译和主持，请问。讲课中说，地球上的某些地方是灵性世界在地球上的展示。Krishna 在 Vrindavan 的显现是他本人，那其他那些同游也是本人显现吗？还是其他都显现成普通人进入生死轮回呢？感恩您。Obeisance Guru.You mentioned in the lecture that on the earth, some places are manifestation of the place from spiritual world. And Krishna in Vrindavan is Krishna himself. Then the question is that his associates are also manifestation of this Krishna's association themselves.Or are they manifested as ordinary persons, they are entering in the cycle of birth and death.
Are they, they're never ordinary persons, but they appear like ordinary persons.
他们从来都不是普通人，只是他们显得像是普通人，显现的好像是普通人一样。So
they come to this world to take part in Krishna's pastimes, and then they appear to leave the world, just like the Yadu dynasty. They annihilated each other, they fought with each other, they drank wine, and then they fought with each other and they killed each other.
进入这个物质世界呢，是为了从事消食光。然后他们当他们离开这个物质世界的时候呢，好像是就像普通人那样离开这个物质世界，就像亚度族人，他们就是喝了酒，喝醉了酒之后呢，就开始互相杀戮，之后他们就离开了。
But it was all Krishna's pastimes. It was his arrangement so that they could go back to their place in the spiritual world. Or some of the people who came, they were demigods, so they went back to the heavenly planets. Some great souls, they come to the world, and they stay in this world for some time, and then they leave the world. But their death, they're taking birth and they're dying, although it appears to be material, it's not ordinary. They're not under the laws of material nature. But they appear to be taking birth, they appear to be dying.
表面上看呢，好像是他们降生了。表面上看，从外在的看来，好像是他们离世了。But
we should understand their body is not they're actually transcendentally situated. They're not under the laws of material karma.
但是我们要明白的一点，他们地位是超然的，他们从来不受制于物质的这个karma因果法则的，不受制于物质的因果法则。So
we should never think the pure devotees are ordinary people who take birth and die.
我们永远不要把纯粹的奉献者认为纯粹奉献者是普通人，像普通人那样出生又离世。还有问题吗？还有，下一个是来自于淡然一笑，Krishna知觉是自然而然的发展，感官享乐是要控制，但是。 灵性进步不是一夜就能达成的，这边呢要控制着不去做感官享乐，那边另外一方面呢还没有在灵性上达，还没有达成灵性，很纠结，玩抖音要控制，但是在就是玩抖音要控制着玩，但是在培养灵性衣服前是无法控制的，对吧？ 没有培养高品位，所以不可能放弃低品位。
Can you translate it?
This is a. So Krishna consciousness should be very naturally developed. We should control our sense gratification, but at the same time, we have not attained those very high spiritual status. So we have to control our senses not to watch this Douyin. But on the other hand, we haven't developed those higher tastes. So we cannot give up those lower tastes.
Anyway, you should feel some disgust for that lower taste, and we should desire to develop the higher taste.
无论如何，你应该对于这些低品味就感到厌烦，而同时呢，应该渴望发展起高品味。
If we think that I have to take cigarettes and drink alcohol, I have to have illicit sex until I get the higher taste. You'll never get the higher taste that way.
如果你想在发展起高品位之前呢，我先抽点烟，喝点小酒，来点非法的性生活。如果是这样，你这种想法就永远发展不起这种高品位。
So you have to become disgusted with the demands of the senses.
应该对于感官的这些所求，你也感到很厌恶。
Then you can look and try to develop the higher taste. It will take some time.
只有有这种心理之后呢，你才会去寻找。并且发展出更高的品位，这确实是需要时间的。
But first, you have to give up these sinful activities.
首先要放弃罪恶活动。
And sinful activities means those things which have no connection to Krishna consciousness.
什么是罪恶活动？就是跟 Krishna 之间无关的活动。
下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，Pushpa Saradevdasi， 顶拜 Gurudev 的莲花族，顶拜，请问，温达文的居民是怎么培养出对 Krishna 的爱，甚至超过对自己的孩子的爱呢？这种心态是怎么培养出来的呢？How the residents of Vrindavan develop those love for Krishna even more than love for their own children?
Because they perform pious activities over many lifetimes.
这是由于他们生生世世都在从事着虔诚活动。
And these pious activities were all in relation to devotees.
这些虔诚活动都是跟奉献者息息相关的。
So by serving the devotees and by associating and hearing from devotees, then we develop some pious activities. And if we have a lot of that piety, then you can develop. You may one day become qualified to take birth in Vrindavan.
Because they serve the devotees, associate with the devotees, listen to the devotees, so these spiritual activities gradually accumulate to a certain extent, and develop.发展出这种资格，能够投生在温达文了。
But some are residents from the spiritual world, that they're that they live, you know, they've come from the spiritual world, and so they've come to take part in Krishna's pastimes, that they're eternally living there in the spiritual world in Goloka Vrindavan.
有一些呢是从灵性世界下来的，来参加Krishna消时光，他们永恒的是居住在Goloka Vrindavan的。
They are Nitya Siddha devotees, eternally perfect.
他们被称为Nitya Siddha奉献者，永恒完美的奉献者。They
never forgot Krishna.
没有片刻忘记过Krishna. 下一个问题。下一个是Jagateshwari Devadasi，顶拜Guru莲花祖母，顶拜所有奉献者。Guru Dev，有人把不加梵歌书请到家后，发现看不下去，应该怎样帮助他们呢？顶拜Guru Dev。Well,
how to help somebody who got a Bhagavad Gita but didn't read it?
They find that it's very hard, difficult to read this book.
Well, encourage them to hear the holy name, Kirtan, Kirtan and Prasano.
帮助他们聆听圣名，Kirtan，聆听Kirtan，还有荣耀Prasadam.
And become their friend, make a nice friendship with them.
和他们交朋友，成为他们的朋友。And
explain to them that it takes a little time, practice in the beginning, difficult to understand, but just keep trying, little bit, gradually they will get, they can develop a taste and understanding.
要跟他们解释。 就是需要休息，一开始有点困难，但是要坚持不懈，点点滴滴的去做，逐渐的会发展出品味，发展出理解力。Sometimes,
instead of, maybe you give the small books instead of the big book. Maybe the small book is easier to understand.
有的时候呢，就是不如去给他们小书，因为小书要容易理解。Sometimes
good to read, Li Guangshi. That book.
有一本书叫《新世纪瑜伽》，就是讲的是李广师，就这个书很好，理解起来很容易。
Can help us to enter into the understanding of Bhagavad Gita.
可以帮助我们进入对《博家梵歌》的理解。And
sometimes it's easier for people to hear classes rather than to read the book.
有的时候，让人们去听课，就有助于人们理解。
Or you read the book with them. You read the book with them and then discuss. You explain it to them.
或者是您跟他们一起来读，然后跟他们一起讨论，来帮助他们理解。下一个问题。 这位奉献者叫Mobile23BP 这个化名，顶拜Guru，感恩翻译主持，我是毛毛，我想问一下，我到底如何念诵？每个人教的都不一样，有教Hare Krishna， 有的教Hare Krishna， 还有教Hare Krishna， 还有 Krishna 的。 This devotee is puzzled about the exact
pronunciation.
How pronounced it is, yes.
Well, if I tell you, I may be wrong myself. I don't. listen to Prabhupada. Listen to Prabhupada's tapes. You can hear Prabhupada chanting.
那也许我跟你说完，我自己可能也说的不对，所以你请您听那个Prabhupada的念诵。Listen
to Prabhupada's chanting. That's very nice. Just chant like him.
Prabhupada的唱诵非常优美的，就像Prabhupada那样，请念诵。
It's not the pronunciation which is so important. What is important is the devotion.
发音，他们的发音，重要的不是他们的发音，重要的是奉爱。
In different parts of the world, in different places, people speak with different accents and they will pronounce differently.
就是在 全世界各地，他们都有各地的口音，所以他们的发音也是各不相同。People
in China speak different from people in Russia, and people, you know, everywhere in India it's also different. North India different from South India.
中国人的发音呢，跟俄罗斯人的发音不一样。俄罗斯人的发音又跟印度人的发音不一样。北印度人的发音又跟南印度人的发音不一样。So
the important thing is Krishna wants devotion. He's not worried so much about your pronunciation.
Krishna 在意的是您的奉爱，他对于您的发音并不是非常在意的。
下一个问题。
下一个，叶倩，顶拜孤鲁和所有奉献者，不能有规律的念诵，有时候会有骄傲的心态，怎么去克服呢？
Well, you have to beat your mind. You have to become humble. You have to get strong association, somebody who will push you, make you chant.
你需要去把你的心意变得谦卑，需要强有力的联谊，需要有人去推动你去念诵。You
need to surrender. You have to give up your independent mood. Yes, you're too proud. You should understand this is your stupidity, this is your ignorance.
你需要臣服，放弃您独立的心态。你要认识到，就是您现在，是有骄傲的心态，这是愚蠢的，这是很没有意义的。Are
you serious to be a devotee? If you are, then you have to chant.
您是不是认真真的想成为奉献者呢？ 如果您真的想当一个奉献者的话，就要必须要念诵。So
control the higher self, control the lower self by the higher self.
要用你更高层面的自我控制你那个低层面的自我。
It's like you have two wolves, you have two persons in your heart. One is the low person, one is the high person.
就好像你内心有两个人，一个人呢是那个就是更进步的那个人，还有一个是层面比较低的人。So
don't feed that low nature. Don't feed it, starve it.
不要给那个本性低级的那个人给他食物，给他营养，要让他饿着。下一个问题。下一个是最后一个问题，第九 Amy, Amy, 上海，顶白姑的莲花族。早安吉祥，早安吉祥，冬至到了，我爸爸的骨灰一直安放在寺庙的宫殿里，我每年都会去两次到三次祭拜。按照 Krishna 之觉，除了念诵圣名外，还有其他什么方式可以祭祀祖先呢？感恩 Guru。
Well, just then, you should become a pure devotee, and then you can deliver your father.
您需要自己成为一个纯粹的奉献者，之后呢，就可以拯救你的、救赎你的父亲了。
Just like Prahlad Maharaj delivered his father.
Prahlad Maharaj 就拯救了他的爸爸。
His father was a big demon. Lord Narsingadev killed him.
他爸爸是个大恶魔，被主Narsingadev所杀。
But because his son was a very good devotee, the father got liberation.
因为儿子是优秀的奉献者，因此父亲也得到了解脱了。
So you have to become a good devotee, and then your father will benefit greatly.
您自己应该成为一个优秀的奉献者，这样您的父亲能够从中获得巨大的益处。
Okay, finish.
还有最后一个，还又来一个。Shyamasaki Hare Krishna, 顶拜亲爱的 Gurudev, 顶拜所有的奉献者。一直以来，我不断祈祷主庇护我传教顺利，让更多人走进 Krishna 知觉。我也做了努力，可总是困难重重。是不是 Krishna 不喜欢我，不接受我的服务，使我陷入困境之中呢？This devotee has been praying to Lord to give her shelter so that she can preach smoothly and make more people enter into Krishna consciousness. She had made a lot of endeavor, but there are so many obstacles. So she is asking, is that because Krishna doesn't like her and doesn't accept her service?Make her into a difficult situation.
Well, you have to prove your sincerity to Krishna. You have to show him that you're sincere. You have to be patient and you have to wait. It will take time.
你需要向 Krishna 证明您的真诚。您需要有耐心，需要时间。
It's not that you just pray to Krishna and immediately Krishna gives you what you want. Krishna wants to see you're really sincere, you're really genuine. So you have to be patient.
不是说您前一秒钟向 Krishna 祈祷之后，下秒钟 Krishna 马上就会应验您的祈祷。Krishna 需要去看一下您是不是真的真诚，所以呢，您需要耐心。
Just like when you get married, the wife wants a child immediately. She has to wait, take some time. So the same way, you have to be patient.
就好像当新婚之后，妻子马上就希望有自己的小宝宝，但是她需要等待，需要时间。同样的，你也需要时间。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
没有了。
好，今天结束了，感谢 Guru Mani 真泰的翻译，感谢萨提，就这。
Hare Krishna, Gurudev。所以他 Saki 好像要问问题，但是他还没打上来。您时间还方便吗？
需要多长时间？
我。不知道，我回头这样吧，我让他单独发给我，我再发给您吧。
好，可以。
好，那我们今天早课就先到这里。
好，
谢谢 Gurudev。
感谢奉献者，聆听，感谢。 Hare Bol, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.
Gaur Premanande, Hare Bol.